टुडे वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट ब्लड बाथ इन द दलाल स्ट्रीट निफ्टी फ्री फॉल. यू सी आई हैड रिटन टू आर्टिकल्स ऑन द स्टॉक एंड फाइनेंशियल मार्केट्स. वन वॉज दैट द निफ्टी विल बी रेंज बाउंड बिटवीन 5th ऑफ दिसंबर टू 16th ऑफ जनवरी बिटवीन 16,700 टू 18,000 एंड इट विल बी मोस्ट वॉलेटाइल because the planetary positions in the month of December are most venomous. You talk about the solar ingress in Sagittarius, you talk about the lunation charts, everything seems to be on a rough patch. You see, first of all, the solar eclipse has taken place on the 4th of December, and before that there was lunar eclipse on the 19th of November. Now it is obvious, and as per the mundane classics, see, whenever there is eclipse, whenever Mars activates the eclipse point, then there is the, first of all, the things start happening, but when Mars activates the eclipse point, it explodes. So the first explosion for the Mars to activate the eclipse point was on the 8th and 9th of December, which I had predicted much before that. And this is the result of the solar ingress in Virgo also, because Mars and Saturn both became Marak, and because the sign rising was Gemini and Mars and Saturn were both in the 8th house with Gemini sign, and when Mars will activate the Marak, things would explode. And we have seen for ourselves, I had mentioned that it will be explosive. Mars is known for explosion, and we have seen the chopper crash. Now Venus ingressed in Capricorn on the 8th of December. Now Venus, this particular transit of Venus is not that simple. People do not understand. Venus normally stays in a house for 18 days, and it is going to stay here for 112 days. Parallel to 2013 and 14, when it stayed for 116 days in the sign Capricorn, the same sign. And we had Ebola virus from the West Africa, and now we have had Omicron from South Africa. So things are parallel. I had mentioned December is going to be most volatile, and then I had predicted the solar ingress of Sagittarius is also not a good transit. First of all, I had mentioned that Sun normally stays in a sign for 30-31 days, and Sagittarius is the only sign in which Sun stays there for 29 days. It is less than 30 days. So friends, it is not pious, but it is in a friendly sign. And it is also called a karmas. All the wars in the world have taken place when Sun is in Sagittarius. Mahabharata also took place when Sun was in Sagittarius. And on the 16th December at 3:44 hours, when Sun ingresses in Sagittarius, there is Kal Sarpa Yoga also. All the planets are eclipsed in the, they are gripped in the Rahu and Ketu axis till 24th of April. And then simultaneously, Mars is also with Ketu, and it is reaching the eclipse. First of all, it activates the eclipse point of the lunar eclipse. Now it is proceeding towards activation of the eclipse point of the solar eclipse. And mind you friends, I have also mentioned the day, I have already mentioned the dates. On the 1st of January, and rather to be fine-tune it, on the 30th of December, Mars and Moon together will be at 18 degrees with Ketu. It is most venomous and both will be in Jastha star. The world most tragic happenings and ugliest things have happened when Mars is in Jastha star. Mars is in Jastha star, a most ferocious and bitter star. And I had mentioned, I had also predicted coronavirus second wave when Ketu goes in the sign Scorpio and enters Jastha star. And we have seen for ourselves. So till the time Mars is in Jastha star, the world's most ugliest things can happen. You can see what is happening. Earthquake in Indonesia, then earthquake in Fiji, and then what is happening in Philippines, what is happening in Indonesia, what is happening in US, and then the surge in the virus. There's a lot of panic. I had mentioned that there will be a lot of panic, then danger. And that's what is happening. Now the sentiments of the investors is broken. So it is not easy for it to recover till you get any respite from virus. And on the 19th, I had specifically mentioned 19th, that 19th Venus will go in retrogression. Venus becomes very strong when it is retrograde, but when it falls, it loses the complete shine. And whichever planet it will be placed with, it will spoil that planet also. And on the 1st of January, Venus is in the 4th house, it is aspecting the 10th house, it is with Sun, aspecting the 10th house, and the 2nd house is having Mars and Ketu in the solar ingress of Sagittarius. The 2nd house has got Mars and Ketu. 2nd house, Mars is there, so it shows a strong 2nd house, but it is spoiled by Ketu. So it shows the economic condition of the country will not be good. And till Mars and Ketu are together, till 16th of January, things will be most volatile. And then today there was also star exchange between Saturn and Moon. And whenever Moon is in own sign, normally the markets take a hit. The markets, it's a bearish trend. So there is a star exchange also. Tomorrow also there is a star exchange. I don't think we can get any respite even tomorrow. Maybe day after tomorrow there may be little recovery. But my feeling is even tomorrow is not good. But let me tell you, friends, it is very difficult to predict day to day. I don't say that my prediction can be correct for day to day, but I can give you a broad spectrum. I've already mentioned the broad spectrum that till 16th of January, it will be most volatile and will touch the maximum and the minimum lows. So, and my predictions for the virus have also turned out true. I had written an article on the 12th of, I don't remember, 12th of April, that this virus will come after the 8th of December and it will create panic. And that is what it is. And even this panic has created, instability in the stock and financial markets. It has spoiled the sentiment of the people. People are afraid because now more than 84 countries are having this virus and it is growing in geometrical progression. What is the net outcome we have to see after 10-15 days? What is going to, because Mars is going to activate and Venus has become retrograde and it is parallel to the 2013-14. So friends, it is not easy. It can get complicated also, because as per the Yugadi, the Pisces new moon chart of 2021-22 is also not a healthy chart as far as India is concerned, as far as UK is concerned. Those Yugadi charts I had discussed in my article of 12th April 2021, and I specifically mentioned about UK. So friends, this is all I just wanted to say, that my predictions have been spot on even for financial astrology. Now, earlier they were not, there were some shortcomings in my predictions as far as financial astrology is concerned, but now for the last 3-4 months I've been working very hard to give some predictions, and I find that my predictions are proving spot on, and especially the activation of Mars and activation of the Jyestha star. So friends, this is all I just wanted to share. Have a good day, best of luck, take care. Do not invest. I had also mentioned, do not invest in December. Be very careful. Keep away from the stock market in the month of December. Let's see what happens after 16th of January. But till 16th of January, things can be most volatile. The market can swing either way. It can swing positive also. But the sentiments are very bad. Sentiments are extremely bad because of the virus. There are 3-4 major factors which have brought about a bloodbath in the stock and financial markets. So this is all, friends, I just wanted to share with you. Thank you for listening to me. Have a good day. Bye-bye.